recipe button allows you to change the values of up to 99 tags with a single button press. In this example, we have three different recipes, changing the quantities of these ingredients. You can see each button press is modifying all four of the ingredients with a single button press. Also notice that the recipe button doesn't change when I click on it. So we added indicators to remind us which button had been pressed. There's a trick for that that we'll show you in the example. So let's get right to it. Double click or drag the recipe button onto the screen. The first page of the dialog has all of the formatting options that we covered in the How to Use Objects Common Features video. The second tab is where we get the work done. You just fill out a table with up to 99 entries of which tags get what data when the button is pressed. Let's fill out a few. We click on the Add button, grab a tag, let's grab almonds, set the value, and say add. Let's grab another tag. How about peanuts? We'll make him 45. Another one, how about raisins? And we'll do one more. How about sugar? Close when you're done. And now we have our new recipe. These tags are going to get these values each time the recipe button is pressed. Note that you do need to be a little bit careful here. If you add another tag, let's add the peanuts tag, which we've already added, and we'll change the value to something like 77. Say close. Now the peanuts tag will be set to 45, but then later in the list it'll be changed to 77. So the 77 will replace the 45. On a short recipe like this, it's obvious, but on a long list it might not be so apparent, so be careful that you don't overwrite the values when creating these tables. That's all there is to setting up a recipe button. Let's take a look. We'll resize it, move it, simulate it, save the project, and up pops our new recipe button. Currently all those tags are set to 0, but when I press the recipe button, it updates all the tags in one fell swoop. We still have the issue, though, that when you click on the recipe button, it doesn't appear to change, so it doesn't tell the user that anything really happened. How do we get the recipe button to look like it changes? Let's bring up that first example and take a look. If we double-click on a recipe button, we can see the answer. Over here on the recipe, we've added additional tags. These tags keep track of which recipe button has been pressed. So when we press recipe button 1, it sets recipe button 1's tag, but turns off the other tags. Likewise, recipe button 2 turns off recipe button 1, but turns on recipe button 2. And 3 does the same thing. It turns on 3, turns off 2 and 1. Then we just put some indicators on the screen that monitor those tags. So that's how we're keeping track of which button has been pressed. If we simulate that real quick, we can see that when we press button 1, it turns on his tag and turns the other two off. Button 2 turns on his tag, turns the other two off, and 3 does the same thing. So now the user can see which recipe is currently being displayed on the panel. One last trick. You can take these indicators and lay them on top of the recipe buttons. Let's try that real quick. If I grab these indicators and simply put them on top of the recipe buttons, and we missed a little bit, let me fix that. My recipe buttons need some work here, but you got the idea. Let's simulate that. Now when we click on the recipe button, it looks like the recipe button is lighting up, but it's actually the indicator that's sitting on top of the recipe button. So that's a neat trick to make your recipe buttons look like they're changing state and act like radio buttons. Well, that's it for this video. Be sure to check out all the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.